Hey.
Hello! Oh wow! Oh my God! You need to turn. I need to see the whole. I love the mustache.
Thank you.
Wow! I was like, oh my God! I was so excited because you told me, oh, can I do like something? But I didn't know exactly what it would be. I love it! I love it!
Thank you so much.
How long? First of all, listen, I'm so excited that I have so many things to ask you that I need to calm down. So first of all, welcome and thank you so much for doing this with me today.
Thank you for inviting me. I'm very excited.
Yes, that's what we like. We like that attitude. So yes, would you like to introduce yourself and tell us a few things about yourself?
Yeah, sure. So my name is Atticus, and I do drag. As you can see, I'm a drag king, and I've been doing it for a couple months now. My pronouns are he, him. Yeah, I'm 20 years old. That's about it, I guess.
Yes, it's amazing because when you told me also like how old you are and how long you've been doing it, I was in shock because when I saw your profile, I mean, I saw it and you had like two pictures or something, and I was like, oh, I bet he has like another profile and this is like maybe something happened and he's done like a new profile. But then you said to me something which is like fairly new that you've just been doing it, like as you said, like a couple of months. And I was like, are you sure? Because it's amazing. Okay, so let's start from the start. How did you get into drag?
Well, when I was younger, I always loved doing makeup or like painting on my face or something like that. And just recently, two friends of mine helped me get into it. They both do, have been doing drag for a longer time, and they like put me in makeup and outfit and everything. And yeah, that's kind of where I was like, okay, I'm gonna do this. I love it, so.
Yes, definitely. And so it's not something that, because a lot of the times growing up, you have the, okay, I'm going to try this. But for you, it was something that you kind of wanted for years, let's say, because as you said, growing up, you had that, makeup, dressing up part. But like I need everyone that's watching or whoever sees this live after definitely need to go and follow you and see all your photos because it's amazing. It's like you've been doing it for so many years.
Yeah, thank you so much.
I want to ask you the first question is, how did your family and friends, let's say, take it in?
Well, my family, my mother, she was very excited about it, and she kept asking me like, "How do you do it? What? Why?" You know. And I showed her some pictures. She follows me on Instagram as well, and she supports me a lot, actually.
Oh wow. Yeah, that's amazing. That's very good because so many times we hear all these stories of people, not whether it's drag, whether it's just being gay, whether it's trans, anything from this community that the stories are awful. People kicking out their children or getting bullied. Did you ever had not as you said, because your mother is supportive towards you, but did you ever have like negative feedback from someone?
About my drag, not really. I've actually been very lucky, and my environment is very supportive, so that's really nice. Yeah, I haven't had any negative reactions to my drag, so that's great. Yeah.
That's good, and let's hope it stays that way. Is there like someone that you have, because let's say someone that wants to become a singer, they might have, for example, as a role model, Madonna. I don't know, whoever everyone likes. Do you have someone that inspires you in that way?
Honestly, Not really, not yet. I do follow a lot of people on Instagram, of course, but I don't really know exactly what direction I want to go. So I'm just kind of feel like figuring it out. I'm just trying out everything.
So because I don't, I mean, I know some information because I have friends that do it also. So obviously I have an idea, but I know that a lot of people have, let's say, a character that they would follow. Or for example, when I was doing a bit of research before our interview, I saw that a lot of people, for example, have, like, if someone is doing, let's say, drag queen, they will go down the path of, let's say, more of cosplay, like anime. Then you have other people that will go, you know, so everyone has kind of, not everyone, but a lot of people have a character, let's say. Is that something that, you know, you would do or you're doing? Because obviously, as you said, it's something which is new.
Yes, I've been looking in the direction of like fantasy with elves and kind of that like magic, that kind of stuff that really interests me, and I just think it's really beautiful, like that whole world is so like different and just magical to me. So I really want to explore more in that direction. I think,
Yeah, I
yeah.
remember because I saw the, I mean, some of your posts, but and the last one was with was it an elf theme?
Yes, yes.
I love elves. Like, I feel it's like you said, it's something which is like so magical, and they're always so pretty and beautiful. And yeah, so is it something, because that's something which I do know from friends of mine, which is kind of, let's say, pricey, and it costs a lot, the makeup, the clothes. Like, yeah, give us some information about that. Like, if someone decides to start now, what would you tell them?
In the beginning, you definitely have to like buy a lot of makeup because you need a lot of different things, but I think you can definitely do it with a budget. It doesn't have to all be expensive, and the clothes don't all have to be like this big thing that's costing you a lot of money and you can only wear one side. You can reuse things, and with makeup, you can definitely save a lot of money on just going for it. Different brands. It doesn't have to be expensive, but it definitely can be very expensive. Yeah.
Yes, I bet. Is there, okay, so I don't know if you have a lot of friends that do it, that, you know, kind of you could get some help, or if, for example, you know, you have, let's say, locally, there might be a basketball team. Locally, there might be a theater team. Is there, because I don't know from where you are, you're from the Netherlands, correct?
Yes.
I don't know how it is like with drag shows, like other shows you can go, other shows you can perform, or the, let's say, like teams.
I honestly do not really know yet because with COVID, my friends who do that haven't really performed either. I don't really know how it all works here. I would love to perform eventually. Once you know that's possible again, and my friends they do a lot of photo shoots with something I'm really interested in, and yeah, I think yeah, interviews like this, but for performances, I don't really honestly don't really know because I just haven't done that.
Well, yes, because yes, it's something that you have just started. But would you go down that path? Would you go down the path of, let's say, performing? Because I'm guessing there is a lot of options when doing drag. So I'm guessing you have, as you said, you could do the photo shoots, or you could do, you can perform in shows, as I have friends of mine that do that part. Like, what would you prefer to do?
I definitely love doing the photo shoots and just, you know, using social media, but I would also really want to try to perform. I think that's very interesting, even though I don't really know how it all goes. I want to try it, yeah.
Do you think, because I mean, I don't know, you might know, but as you said, because it's something that you're kind of trying to figure out now, and obviously COVID hasn't helped at all. Is it something that's, let's say, not easy exactly? Let's say actually about where you live, like your country. Do you think as a country it's supportive in you know, community of, let's say, the community of drag only now? Do you see, you know, you might walk down the street and see, okay, they have a show here tonight. Like, do you think that people are supported towards drag queens and drag kings?
I definitely think some groups of people are very open to it. There's always going to be, you know, groups that are more, that aren't interested in it or that just don't like it. I feel like it's very divided here, but there's definitely a lot of support. Yeah.
Oh, wow. Okay. That's good to hear, because you all, I'm from Greece, so usually people are not supportive, like in the community in general, towards the community actually. And especially for someone that does drag, it would be like a lot of negative feedback. Which that's really bad, especially in the time and age we live now. I mean, I feel like after so many years, like, things would be better. I mean, I understand that it's usually older generations, yeah. But I feel a lot of parents will pass that on, so you still get that bullying, you know, the looks. And even for, you know, simple things. But when it comes to drag, maybe things are getting better. I'm not, like, quite sure. But I was just curious how it works there. But that's good that there's the support. But you said it's something you've started now. Is it easy to find people that do drag? Like, do you think it's easy? Let's say someone starts now. Which you've started now, so you are the perfect example. How can you get in touch with people that are doing the same thing?
I think right now, definitely social media, because going out isn't, like, not a thing right now.
Yeah.
So meeting new people that way is kind of difficult. I feel like in social media you can get very far, because you just, you know, type in drag and then whatever country or place you live, mm-hmm. I assume you'll find many people. And if, I think once you know a few, then you easily get to know many more through them.
That's good, because a lot of the times I've heard, like, from that goes for lots of things. Like, it could be something that someone does. I will give you a simple example, because I was always into basketball as a sport, but depending what team you were, like, if I went to a different area and that team was, like, really good, you would usually get the people that, you know, who is this new person, like, we are better, and you always get that bullying, which is really bad, because, you know, at the end of the day, everyone's doing the same thing. Yeah. And you also, it's the same with drag and, like, even, like, anything that's, you know, whether it's a hobby, whether it's a job, you always get that. I've even got that from jobs, that instead of when someone new comes, to have that, okay, you know, it's someone new, let's make this person feel comfortable, let's make them, you know, you always get people that are like, you know, who's this person now? Like, who do you think you are? Like, you get that. But you said you got a lot of support, which that's
well. My friends who helped me get into track have supported me a lot, really. Only support from them, honestly. But I think there's definitely a lot of competition in the community. Mm. Especially since you've got, like, Drag Race.
Yes.
Things like that on TV. So, I think there's a lot of competition. I don't really know how, like, it is to have more friends in drag yet, but I'm sure it can be a lot of fun too.
I think it's, you always get the good side and the bad side. I just think it's managing to find, let's say, the right people to hang out with. And I think it is the same for anything, like even if it's for every day, you know, the friends, I mean, even our parents always say, like, watch with who you hang out with and all that. Like, I feel it's the same because, but I just hate that part because already as a community, there is that bullying.
Yeah.
Whatever, whether it's being gay, being drag, being trans, anything from the community or in general. And instead of, you know, you should have that support. Like if someone, you know, like you are starting now. I mean, yes, you got like a lot of support and all that, but you need to be like, okay, who is this new person? You know, let's make them feel comfortable. Let's help them. I get the competition part because drag, you, even if someone doesn't know what it is, you can like kind of figure out that it would be competitive because, you know, it's like, you know, who has the best clothes, who has the best makeup. So I get that part, but at the same time, you know, you have the good competition, let's say, the competition, competitive, of being like, okay, yes, let's see who's best, but without the mean part.
Yeah, exactly.
So like, I think, you know, you need to have a balance with everything.
I mean, I think competition is good as well, because that way everyone just keeps evolving if you keep wanting to get better and better.
Yes, for sure. But that's the thing, you know, you don't want anyone to feel bad. You need to have that, as you said, in order to get better, not to make anyone feel bad. But yeah, you always get all of the sides. What I also want to ask you is, you said to me, like, you like that magical part of the drag, of, as you said, with elves, but where do you get your inspiration? So you might be, it could be from movies, it could be from Instagram, like where your main, you know, where do you get your inspiration for exactly?
Well, I get a lot of inspiration from Pinterest.
Mm-hmm.
Different pictures of like everything. Depends on what I like want to go for a specific look. But most of the time when I think, oh, I want to create something like that, it's either from a movie or from like a video on YouTube.
Mm-hmm.
The elf look is kind of inspired by Lord of the Rings. I don't know if you've seen it, but
I love it. I have the books, the DVDs, everything.
I love it too, and it's kind of inspired by Legolas, the elf.
Yes. So,
yeah. That's mainly where I get inspiration from, I guess, movies and videos. Yeah.
Okay, so let's say someone says to you, okay, yes, well, actually not someone says to you, you decide to, as you said, you got this inspiration from Lord of the Rings, or maybe you see something similar, as you said, on Pinterest. Okay, so you find a picture. I want you to tell me, like, what are the stages? Okay, so you would be, like, going on Pinterest, find the picture. Like, what do you do next? Like, how long does it take you? Where can you find? Because someone, for example, might start now, but they don't know where to look. I'm sure it's a lot of research in order to find products, clothes. I saw, because on your last picture, you know, different jewelry or anything that you would add. Like, tell me the whole process of it.
Okay, so first I just start saving pictures on Pinterest, seeing what I want to do with the makeup. Mm-hmm. And most of the time, I just start putting on makeup and I find different accessories that are laying around. But those ears, for example, I bought them a little while ago and I was like, okay, I'm going to create something with this. Sometimes you find a piece of jewelry or an accessory and you create a look more around that.
Mm.
So it really depends on what your first initial idea is. If I have an idea for a specific makeup look, then that will be the inspiration and I'll just build the rest around it. But if I find something like those ears, then I use those and then I just build like the outfit and the makeup around those ears.
What is your goal to be only around the elf part, because like the one that we put for the photo you did, we the one that we have as a poster for the interview we are doing now. Like, how did you come up with that character?
Well, that's actually the very first time ever I went into drag. So my two friends put the makeup on, and the beard is actually inspired by the Hunger Games. I don't know if you have seen the movie.
I have, of course.
Well, there's this one character in it who has a very, like, very specific, very kind of, extra beard. That's what we ran for. And the styling and everything kind of came together after they put the makeup on. So,
how long does it take you to? I mean, I'm guessing it's different for depending what path you want to go down and how you want to dress and the makeup. But approximately, like, how long would it take you? Let's say for something that's very simple, because I'm guessing you've tried a lot the past months, but okay, so what would be the minimum time, and then what would be like the max, like what's the longest?
The longest, I think, I could definitely spend like 4 to 5 hours, but
5 hours,
I don't know if that's always gonna stay that long, because I feel like eventually I will get a little faster and better at things. But it takes very long sometimes. I'm like a little ambitious and I'm like, oh, I'm going to do this and that. And then I end up just spending so long on like only my beard. And I'm like, okay, no, I'm exhausted.
Yeah, but that makes sense though, because I don't know, drag fascinates me. I don't think I could ever do it because I'm bored to even do like everyday makeup. So I don't think I would be able to do something like that. But I don't know, it just fascinates me so much. But I just feel it takes like a lot of time, like as you said, 4 to 5 hours. And I think even when, you know, as you said, because it's something new, okay. But I feel that even like if you do it for years, it still takes that time, because I feel most people that do it are perfectionists. I don't know, I have that idea for people who drag. So I feel like, you know, you would do something and you won't change it up, and then you do want to just so it looks perfect. And then you have, you know, people that do drag that are so extra that I don't know how long it takes them. Like, but it amazes me. Like, if you see people, you know, like every day, and then they will show you, even like friends and people that I know, you know, if you see them every day and then they show you a picture of drag, it's like, are you sure? Is this you in the picture? Like, yeah, it just fascinates me so much. I think I told you this, but it's art. Like, I don't think everyone can, you know, I think you really need to have a passion in order to do something like that.
Yeah,
tell me, sorry.
Well, I think so too, because if you don't have a passion for something like this, then you'll just get bored by it. You have to have fun doing it and want to do it and enjoy creating new things and making up a whole like fantasy world of your drag. Yeah.
For sure. Are you studying, working? Because I mean, you're very young, so I don't know what you're doing right now, because obviously, as you said, it takes a lot of time, and also if you have photo shoots and all that, like, it takes a lot of your time. Do you have, how can you, I mean, I don't know if you study or work, like, do you do either of those two?
I study dance, so it's definitely takes up a lot of time. I feel like if I just stick to a schedule, then it will be okay. And for now, I see drag more as a hobby, so yeah, my study definitely goes first. So if I don't have time to do a look and take pictures, then I'll just, you know, skip a post or something like that. Because for now, I don't earn anything doing drag yet. It's really just for me. And I absolutely love doing it, but I also have to study.
That's good. I like that mentality. Studies come first. But even what you study is something, you're again in the art part of things. How is that? Like, how are the studies? What do you do exactly?
Well, it's mainly just dance classes, honestly. We also get some, like, what's it called? Like, just a book and the teacher tells you.
Yeah.
But it's mainly just classes and just dancing.
Do you specialize on something, you know, because you have like ballet and then you have more street dancing. Is it something that you specialize or is it a variety of dancing?
I specialize in like ballet and also a bit of modern dance. So.
Nice. Wow, amazing. What would be your, okay, so let's say, obviously, you, as you said, studies come first. Well done for that. but after that, like for your goals as a drag king, what would, you know, for your future, because it's something which is, it's new, like for later on in the next years to come, what would, you know, be your top goal?
I feel like I want to try performing and see if I like it, if I like doing it. And if I do, I definitely would want to continue because I feel like it's some, I think it would be fun, but maybe I'll just don't like it at all. I don't know. So that's definitely something I want to maybe focus on in the future once I can. And I'm also just, I think for now, my plans are to keep my social media up and just try gain a little bit of a platform, keep posting, just have fun with it, really. I think
that's the best way to go, because usually when you have fun with something, it's usually when you manage to achieve a lot, instead of pressurizing yourself of seeing it as a job. I mean, you can do both, obviously, of course, but I feel when you put that pressure on yourself, it's not like it's gonna have a negative outcome. Again, it's gonna have a positive if you put the work and the effort and have that patience. But yeah. I feel when you actually, someone enjoys it and you're not, okay, how many views am I getting? How many, you know, when you don't have that, yeah, we all have that. Even when, with me starting this page of storytelling, people sharing the stories, it's that, you know, you always have that thing. Everyone wants the followers. Everyone wants, you know, people to see them and see what they're doing. But I feel that that's the best thing, because that's what I've managed through this page. It's because I actually enjoy it so much. I don't care as much. And I see that all of this feedback I'm getting is amazing.
Yeah, that's, it's, you know, great.
Because you don't have that anxiety. Yes, you wanted to get somewhere, but at the end of the day, you know, you need to enjoy it, because otherwise it's not worth it. It's the same, you know, with what you're saying. If, for example, someone, I don't know, hires you for a photo shoot or something, and obviously it takes a lot of time to, as you said, prepare and, you know, find the clothes, find the makeup, and it's going to take you 5 hours and you're not enjoying it, you know, at the end of the day, it's not going to be worth it. No, you need to love what you do. Like, I agree with that.
It's fun.
Yes, it needs to be fun. Yes, you can have both. But is it something that you've learned through drag? It could be something that someone told you. It could be, I don't know, maybe an interview from another drag king that, you know, inspired you. Like, what are the things? I mean, I know you've been doing it only a couple of months, but yeah, is there something that, you know, stayed with you, something that you shared, something that you learned, like a lesson?
A very special moment for me was when I first went into drag, and I saw myself and I realized that I could be myself in so many different ways. And I've heard many other people talk about this as well, that when you're in drag, you can feel like you're kind of a different person, but at the same time, to me, it feels like I'm more myself than ever like was before. I feel like right now I'm really starting to explore myself as well and what I like and what I want to do. So I guess in a way it can take you very far from who you are, like with the makeup and everything, and you're completely different. But at the same time, you put so much of you in it that it's really just a very big version of yourself.
I love that. That was amazing. I've heard that also from people that do drag, that they feel, as you said, you know, you get, maybe it's because you get that, I'm guessing because it's something that, you know, when you do it, as we said, it's something that you really have to love, and because it's it takes a lot of effort. So it's the same, I'm guessing, with people, you know, that love singing. Like if they go on stage, they feel, you know, it's their, you know, this is who I am now. And as the queen says, yes, you are always yourself, just the best version of you. There you go. That's true. But yeah, so do you get that confidence when you are doing drag? Do you feel,
definitely,
is it like a boost of confidence, let's say?
Yeah, definitely. I feel so much more confident when I'm in drag. It's kind of weird, honestly, because in the beginning I was like, oh, what's happening? Like, I'm just so myself right now. But it's a really nice feeling. Yeah.
Is there a character you would like to do in the future? You know, maybe someone, because as you said, you get a lot of inspiration from movies and Pinterest. Is there like a picture of a drag, or maybe it could be like, as you said, it could be just a character from a movie or something else. Not, it doesn't have to be another drag, but you know, that you would be like, okay, I need to do this one day, which is like, it would take hours and hours to do. Like, is there something that you've seen that's like super amazing that would take you, I don't know, like you, it's like a goal?
Well, I would definitely want to do something inspired by Sherlock Holmes sometime. It's very like,
I know that.
It's like, it's very different from what I'm like exploring right now, but I think, I don't know, the character has always just inspired me, and I love like the series and also movies about him, so that's definitely something I want to do.
Well, let me see the comment. Drag gives the ability to present as the person you want to be without feeling like you will be judged by regular people. And by regular people, I mean heterosexual people. Yes, yes, exactly, because that's what we were saying before, that people, I feel that people, we've talked about it with Kelsey also, that because we've done a live, you know, I feel that people always have something to say.
Yeah.
No matter what you do. And I mean that, yes, you're very lucky in that perspective, because you said you have the support from the family and from friends, which that is amazing, especially at the age that you are, because, you know, obviously when you're younger, you usually soak those things in more than if you're like 30 or 40. But people will always have something to say, and it should never put you down in ways that, you know, to stop you from who you are, or to stop you from, for example, because you're doing drinking now, that, you know, even if you didn't have that support, it should never keep you from, you know, your dreams and goals and what you love to do. Katerina says, have you ever been bullied by anyone because of drag? I think you haven't, because you said you've had that support.
No, I haven't really. Not yet, at least. I'm just, like, very lucky with my friends and my family. So that's amazing. Yeah.
Yes.
But also, because I haven't really been out in drag, I guess. So I haven't really run into people that, you know, might hate it. Yeah.
Yeah, but yeah, what I want to say is that even if, for example, you are wearing, because I had this conversation with friends the other day, is that even if, for example, you wear something which is not, let's say, regular, and I'm not talking about being a drag king or a drag queen, it's, even if it's, I don't know, this shirt, like, for example, you know, because it has a lot of colors and things like that, you know, if I wore this, like, in, I don't know, in Greece or somewhere which is, like, more of a village type, let's say, people would, like, definitely turn around and look, because what is she wearing? Or, like, if you wore, like, which is something very simple, or, like, if you wear, like, a lot of colors or something, like, people will always be, like, you know, what, like, what's going on there? Like, what is happening? But, yeah. And that's, like, something which is very simple, and even today, when I was walking down the street, I saw there was someone that was doing drag queen, and they were just walking down the street. And, you know, people will always turn around and look. And I'm not meaning looking in a, you know, nice way. And a few people always have, even, as I said, even it could be something simple, the way you have your hair, or the way, but I feel drag queen is more hard in that perspective. Than drag kings, I mean, I don't know, I'm guessing. That's what I've understood. That I feel like drag queen probably would get more bullied than drag kings.
I think so too. Yeah. I mean,
yeah.
You know, I see that myself as well. Outside of drag, I'm a trans man, so I do see that trans women often have way harder than I do in that perspective. Yeah.
Yeah, that's really bad. And there was even an incident in Greece. This happened a few days ago, but I think yesterday they found her body, because it was about a guy that, from the moment that he was born as a boy, he always wanted to be a girl. So this is in Greece, in an island, so you can understand, like, how it's like, you know, let's say very small community. And you know, people have had a lot of positive things to say, because he helped with refugees. The pronouns are him and his. Drag community are usually extremely safe. That's why most people present in gay spaces. Our community will always uplift and protect our queens and kings. Oh, that's so nice. but yeah, so even from when he was very young, you know, I'm sorry because I lost my, because I read the comment. Yeah, so he born as a boy, but obviously she always felt as a girl. And then all these stories came up that her parents were putting drugs in her food, like, because they thought she had a mental issue. And growing up, she was bullied a lot. And obviously, being on an island, she, you know, the bullying was a lot. Stories are coming out now, and she ended up being diagnosed with that she had mental issues. And they found her, like, a few days hit by a car and left there.
Yeah.
And that's awful, like, to hear that story, because she was a person that, she helped with refugees, she helped with people that were in need. But because of the community and, like, older generations, you get that bullying. And it's also because, you know, at the end of the day, we are all humans. Like, if you're not bothering anyone by anything, I mean, like, being, like, I don't know, hitting people or killing people or doing, like, things like that, I don't understand why, you know, people get bothered by how people want to dress, or because someone wants to be, you know, a woman wants to be with a woman, or someone wants to be transgender, or they feel how they feel. Like, it doesn't affect you in any way, let's say. So I don't know. I don't know if we're getting better or worse. Like, I don't understand at the end of the day.
I mean, in some ways, it's definitely getting a bit better. There's, like, a lot of awareness and stuff. At least I see way more people now know what, like, being trans even means. But at the same time, as we talk about it more, that also brings up more, that means that people who like don't like it also talk about it more. So I guess then in some way that could also make it a bit worse. But at the same time, raising awareness should always be seen as a good thing.
Not all places are safe spaces. It's okay to do your research and find a safe place to live. Yeah, for sure. I agree with that, because if you can't really be, I mean, I don't think you can change some people. I mean, yes, you can change the world to a better place in some way, but if living in a place which, you know, doesn't bring you that safety in any way, like if you're afraid to walk down the street or, I don't know, being yourself at the end of the day, I mean, you should definitely find somewhere else, because as I told you, the example of the one which was in Greece, and you know, it's an awful story to hear at the end of the day, just because people, you know, can't accept other people, which makes no sense.
It's really sad that you would even have to find a safe place to live, honestly. But yeah, I guess that's just the way it is. So if you're in an unsafe environment, I would definitely say try to find a way out, try to find a better place for you, for your personality to really just be yourself. Because that's the most important thing.
I agree. It is better to be yourself and be mentally healthy than to pretend to be somebody you are not and hate that person, for sure. Yes, I agree that, because I've heard so many stories, even from people that I know, that they won't be the way they want to be. Even, as I said, even if it's something simple of, you know, how you want to dress or how you want to have your hair, or, you know, that someone wants to be, as I said, a woman to be with a woman or a guy with a guy. And I know stories, and it's sad because I know people, and you can't really help if the other person doesn't want to help themselves.
Yeah.
And I know people that would rather pressurize themselves to go according to what the community wants, of, you know, that, okay, you know, if you're a guy, you need to be with a woman and vice versa, and that's it. There is nothing else that we know. But, and I know people that actually do that, like that, you know, yeah. Oh, I'd rather find a guy and marry him and have kids and then, you know, make my parents happy, make the society happy. And it's so sad to hear that, but, you know, you can't really help if the other person, as I said, doesn't want to help themselves, because, you know, you need to know. You can, it's the same with anything, I feel. It's the same if someone has a mental health issue, or if someone has, let's say, a problem with alcohol. You can be there, you can support them, but at the end of the day, they need to help themselves.
Yeah, you really have to come from yourself. If you have like a friend who's struggling, all you can really do is just be there for them, right? Mm. You can't exactly just help them and solve all their problems. That's really something they have to do for themselves.
Yes, for sure. And it's what Kel says. It's you just need to be yourself at the end of the day. Like, if you're not happy with yourself, like, we only have one life.
Exactly.
Yes. Is there something that you want to say, or something that you would like to say that to someone that's starting? Like, anything. It's on you now. Like, anything you want to say, this is your time.
For someone who's just, like, starting with drag and everything, you mean?
Sorry?
For someone who's just starting with drag.
Yes,
right?
Yes. Like, yeah. what is your advice as someone that has just started?
I would say just try to explore. Try as many different things as you possibly can. And don't set boundaries for yourself too quickly. Because in the beginning, you can go every single direction you want. Mm-hmm. Don't make it too hard on yourself by making yourself already do what exactly you want to do for the rest of your life, because that's not going to work. There's so many different things and you have to try it.
Yes, that's, and especially with drag, I feel, sorry for the noise, but I don't know what's happening. I don't know if you can hear. I feel there's a parade underneath. Maybe it's a pride parade, like, who knows? but I feel with drag, you have like so many options that you could do. And as you said, there's so many characters and from movies, or as you said, just by going on Pinterest, I feel Pinterest is the best place. Like, I feel you can find anything, like whether you want to decorate your house in some way, or whether you want to do drag, or you're planning a wedding, or like, I feel you can find like everything there. But is there, that's another question I want to do. Is there a company, let's say for makeup, for clothes, for just for drag?
I honestly don't know. I'm sure there is, right? I mean,
I don't know. I'm guessing like they would be something.
Yeah, it would make sense. There's definitely companies or like people that make wigs, for example, for drag queens. But I haven't really used wigs yet. I did once, but I don't own any myself. So I think definitely in like wigs, there's some special shops for drag queens. I don't know about makeup, honestly. I just use like all random products I can find anywhere.
I'm sure there is, yes, for sure, if someone looks for it. But Kel says, this was great, guys. I have to peace out. And yes, there's actually a wonderful drag queen in Louisville who makes Chantel sparkles. Okay. Maybe we can... There you go. We got. Thank you, Kel. That makes wigs. Okay. I know wigs cost a fortune. Like, I looked once out of curiosity, and they cost a bomb.
Yeah, they do.
But yes, thank you so much for today. I don't have any other questions. I loved it. I don't know if there's something that you want to say or you would like to say.
Well, I just want to say thank you so much for inviting me once again. And I really had a lot of fun. I hope you did too.
I did. I love it. And we should definitely at some point, like later on, like, because you said it's something that you've just started, which it still blows my mind. Like, I've told so many people around me, because as I said, when I saw your profile, I was like, there's no way. There must be another profile somewhere. And something happened and he had to make a new one. Like... because, yeah, you had like 2-3 pictures. So I was like, yeah, he's probably been doing it like for years. And this, like, this is maybe just like for the photo shooting or something. And then you said to me, it's, you know, you've just started it. I was amazed. Like, you're amazing, okay? Like, you need to be like, congratulations. I can't wait, like, to see where it takes you. Like, I'm like, okay, when is the new post gonna be? I'm gonna put a notification.
thank you.
Nice interview, I loved it. Keep it up, dolls. Oh, thank you so much. So thank you for today so much. I loved it. I know you're gonna do amazing things. I will be there following you, and I hope later on. When you're big and great and amazing and everyone knows you, we can have another interview and you can tell me all about it.
Yeah, I would love it.
Thank you so much for today. We will speak again.
Yes, for sure.
Thank you. Have a lovely weekend.
Thank you. You too.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Bye.